Hey everybody, it's your personal trainer, Coach Kozak.
And I'm Claudia, and this is a kettlebell workout.
Throughout the course of this routine, we're going to use a variety of weights ranging between 10 to 50 pounds, but you should choose a weight that's right for your fitness level.
And if you don't have a kettlebell, that's okay. You can actually use a dumbbell instead.
I'm going to be doing the intermediate through advanced exercises.
And follow me for those modifications.
All right, let's get right into it with a quick little warm-up. No weight required for the warm-up. I'm going to do some jumping jacks, where Claudia's just going to go ahead and do a light run in place. If you don't like the higher impact of the jumping jacks, then go ahead and choose the run in place. Whichever one you choose, just keep in mind that this is just a warm-up. The workout is going to be plenty on its own. I promise you that.
Do we just want to warm up? We don't want to expend too much energy here.
Exactly. Making sure to breathe. Just want to warm up those muscles and joints and that overall core body temperature. Just breathing throughout, staying nice and light on the balls of your feet, and keep a slight bend in those knees. Nice, soft, light landings and touches. Let's go ahead and do this one for 5 more seconds. And 3, 2, 1, 0. Next, we're gonna do a high punch out. So we're just gonna take those hands from your chin to up nice and high, getting a full range of motion, punching up. So not little short ones, but make sure to bring them all the way back to your chin every time. Get a little core twist involved in this one as well. And we're just breathing throughout. Warming up those shoulders, triceps, getting them ready for the craziness. That's gonna...
That's don't tell them that.
Oh, I know. Sorry. Yeah, no. It's not crazy. It's easy.
We'll just say it's efficient. How about
let's put it this way. I won't tell you it'll be easy, but I will tell you it will be worth it. You're going to be happy when this one's done. You're going to feel proud of yourself. Let's do this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice. Okay, we're going to go on to an opposite side toe touch. Hands are up. Claudia's just going to go to her knees, but I'm going to come all the way down to my toes. Slight little bend in your knees on this one. Kicking those hips back, feeling a nice stretch in your posterior chain, hamstrings, glutes, lower back. Go ahead and kick those glutes back and stretch them back as you go down. Touching either opposite side, knee, shin, toe, or the floor, depending on your flexibility. Again, the point of this is just to get loosened and warmed up. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Excellent. Okay, warm up is over.
Now the real fun starts, right? Gotta get your weight.
One kettlebell to start. We're gonna do a squat plus one arm row. Mm-hmm. So we're gonna have our feet shoulder width apart. Go and let that kettlebell hang between your legs. We're not gonna count any repetitions today. It's just about getting as many reps in as you can in the allotted time period. Okay, so on this one, hips go back first, break at those hips. And at that bottom portion of the squat, go and pull back on your elbow and then stand back up. So breaking at the hips, squatting until the thighs are about parallel to the ground, and then pull back on that elbow. Keeping our core nice and tight, back stays straight. And pull back from that elbow. Don't pull back from your hand, but instead pretend like you have a string attached to that elbow and somebody's pulling back on it. Making sure to breathe throughout today's workout. It's gonna be very important. You're not gonna make it if you don't. Let's put it that way. We're gonna do equal time on both sides. Keep it up. One rep into the next. You got it. Back stays straight. Let's switch it up in 3, 2, 1, 0, opposite side now. So your one arm gets a little bit of a break, but the legs are gonna keep moving here. Today's workout is definitely a total body routine. Very efficient, getting a lot of work in a short period of time.
You know what that means. It's gonna be some compound movements here.
Yes, coming up, definitely some multiple part movements, combining strength, endurance, plyometric, a little bit of everything, different styles put into this one. The hips back every time, so you don't want it, all that weight over your knees and quads, but instead put it in your hips. Good, let's do this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Excellent. Okay, so next we're going to do a single repetition swing, plus either a bear plank or a step back. So go ahead and put that kettlebell out in front of you. Feet are a little wider than shoulder width. First thing we're gonna do is drive that kettlebell back through your legs. Hips go forward, kettlebell goes up. Back through your legs, set it down. Hands go on the ground. We're either gonna step back or jump back into a bear plank. Claudia's just gonna go ahead and step back up. I'm doing a blast off. Jump back up, and next repetition. I know there's a lot to this one. Go ahead and follow along step by step. We're either hopping back or stepping back into that bear plank. And then that single rep swing is just kicking that kettlebell back through your legs and using your glutes to fire it so your arms are parallel to the ground. So again, a lot of compound movements today. Gonna be some new moves. Gonna take you a couple reps to get the hang of it. But that's okay. It's how we learn new things, right? And every time you come back, it'll be just that much easier. Making sure that when you're jumping up, putting that weight back in your hips here. Nice. Driving those hips forward on that swing. One rep into the next. Again, you decide if it's more appropriate for you to be hopping back or stepping back into that bear plank. Really just choosing the modifications today that are right for you. Good, keep it up. We got this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. All right, moving right into a curl plus a press. So kettlebell in one arm, curling up, palm comes up, get that kettlebell in rack position, go ahead and press while twisting that palm forward. So palm up, and then twist, press up overhead, and back down. So it's four parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. There it is. 1, 2, 3, 4. Excellent. Trying your best not to use too much momentum on this curl. It's not like a clean. Again, it's more of a concentrated curl.
Oh my goodness. And an opportunity to kind of catch your breath.
A little bit. I know it's terrible when a multi-joint movement like this almost feels like a break. That's how you know it's a good workout.
It's because my legs aren't moving.
Yeah, we've been working hard lately. We're feeling it. We're going to switch sides in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Opposite side now. One right into the next. Good. Keep that core tight. Back stays straight. And all of these moves today, I want you to try your best to be machine-like. And what I mean by that is I want every rep to look the same. I want you to be consistent. Try your best not to break form when you get tired. I know it's hard. You'll see me break form sometimes too. But that's what we're aiming for. Good. One into the next. Breathe and keep it moving. Let's do this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. All right, we're going back into that single rep swing. This one's a little bit different though. We're gonna do a single rep swing plus either a jump and deadlift jump or a step and deadlift. So let's start with that single rep swing. So through the legs, back, forward, through the legs, and set it out in front of you. I'm gonna jump forward and then deadlift jump. Claudia's stepping forward and then deadlifting. Now she's stepping back, I'm jumping back. You get the idea. Swing and either jump and deadlift jump or step and deadlift. You decide throughout the course of this workout which one of these is going to be right for you today. Good.
And once you get a hang of the movement, try to pick up the pace a little bit.
Using good form, keeping that weight back in the hips. This one's going to burn out those legs. It's okay though. That's how we know it's working. Try your best, keep that core tight. Back stays straight on this one. Good. One into the next, everybody. You got it. And if you start with the harder variation and then you realize halfway through you need to move on to the easier one, that's okay too. We just encourage you to make this workout your own today. Keep moving, Woo! Keep fighting. Keep breathing. Let's go.
Either version you do, you're going to feel it no matter what.
Oh, they both work. That's for sure. Let's do this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, one and zero.
Nice.
All right, we're standing back up. We're gonna do either a clean or a high pull. Feet are shoulder width apart, slight bend the knees. Going to drop those hips back behind you as you drop the kettlebell down to knee height. And we're gonna bring that elbow up high and explosively. We're either gonna pull that elbow up and then punch underneath and do a clean, or as Claudia is doing, she's just gonna go ahead and bring that elbow up nice and high into a high pull. You decide which variation is right for you. If you're gonna do the clean, you have to emphasize that push and drive underneath. If you don't, what ends up happening is this, which you don't want, that kettlebell flopping around and hitting you in the wrist.
And if you're doing a high pull, again, emphasis with pulling from the elbow and not from the hand, and just using your hips to explosively send that kettlebell up.
That's it, drive those hips forward, get that power, and bring that kettlebell up. Again, doing equal time on both sides. Good, one to the next. You're a machine, let's see it. Good. Hit this one for 10 more seconds on this side. You got it, you got it.
Woo!
Using those legs for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Switch it up, opposite side now. Good. Come on, keep it moving, guys. Pull from that elbow. Using those hips, driving those hips forward. Nice work so far, keep it up. As this workout progresses and gets more tough, really want you to focus on what brought you here today to begin with. What is it? What's that goal? What are you working on? What's your why? Keep it at the front of your mind, not the back of your mind. Let's hit this one for 10 more seconds. You're doing great, keep it up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, switching sides for your hand. Now we're gonna do a gorilla row. Slight bend the knees. Bend over all the way at your waist using your hips as a hinge. Back is parallel to the ground. We're gonna pull across with our elbow coming up high. Again, like somebody's got a rope attached to that elbow. It's called the gorilla row. For these moves where you see Claudia and I performing the same move, your modification is gonna be to lower your weight.
That's right.
So if it's too tough, you can always lower the weight.
And for me, my upper body is always gonna use lower weight than my legs.
And it'll be true for many people. But again, make this workout your own. Pull back from that elbow, guys. Reach across, feel that core working. Keep that back straight on this one. You don't wanna round or hunch over at your back. Let's switch sides in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Opposite side now, right into it. Good. Bending over in this one. We're gonna feel this one in your hamstrings, your glutes, and your lower back, just to go ahead and keep yourself in this stabilized position. Again, as I said at the beginning, very efficient workout today, getting a lot of work in a short period of time. Keep it up, you're doing great so far. There it is, pull back on that elbow, keep that core tight. Big power, you got it. Boom, boom, your power factory, let's go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Let's switch sides now. Ooh. We're gonna do a reverse lunge. Claudia's gonna do it with the kettlebell in rack position. I'm gonna pop it up and I'm gonna do an overhead reverse lunge. Either way, we're dropping that back leg back and dropping both knees until they reach about a 90 degree angle. If you're doing the overhead version, keep that kettlebell straight up, arm stays locked out, core stays tight either way, guys. Nice. Focusing on not bouncing that back knee off the ground. Stay nice and under control. You got it, you can do this. You can do it, guys. You got it, let's go. Breathe. One into the next. Whew. And if you find yourself having trouble, stay balanced. Find a focal point on the wall, something to keep your eyes on. Let's switch in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Opposite side. Right into it, other leg. One leg's resting, the other leg is gonna work. Let's hit it. Breathe. Again, being careful not to bounce that back knee off the ground. It's okay if you lightly touch the ground, but don't bounce it. If you can't quite get this full range of motion, if you step back and just give both knees a slight bend, it's a good beginner modification.
Ah, oh, nice. Goodness.
We're feeling it
this
too.
This is catching up to me.
Right there with you guys. Woo! Come on, let's hit it for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, to the ground we go.
Okay.
Time to work that upper body. We're gonna do an uneven push-up. So either from the knees like Claudia, or on your feet like me, dropping down one hand on that kettlebell. So both elbows reach a 90 degree angle, and you're coming right back up. Keep that core tight, and breathe. Now even that version on the knees is not an easy modification.
Definitely
by
not.
Any means.
No.
So you choose which is right for you.
Make sure you're exhaling on the way up, which is the hardest part of the movement.
You choose the right modification for you. Just keep moving. Name of the game, don't stop. Come on, you got it. You can do it.
Whew.
Let's switch sides in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Opposite side next. All right, let's get right into it. No downtime, guys. No downtime. Don't stop when you get tired. Stop when you're done. Let's do it.
I can't stop, and neither can you.
That's right. We can't break. We can't break. We gotta keep moving. Come on, let's go. It's only fair, guys. Right there working with you. Millions, maybe thousands, doing the same thing at home. Feeling that same burn.
Woo.
Rep by rep, let's get after it. Let's hit it. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Nice. All right, back on our feet for the next one. We're gonna do a sumo deadlift plus either a bear plank or a step back. So first starting with that sumo deadlift, feet are a little wider than shoulder width apart. Weight goes back in the hips, sumo deadlift up, weight goes down, set that weight down on the ground. We both put our hands on the ground. I'm jumping to back, Claudia's stepping back and then forward. But I'm gonna go kick through, hop up, and back into the next. You decide if you just wanna do that step back or if the bear plank plus kick through is more appropriate for you. But either way, once you get back into that position, ready to do that sumo deadlift, make sure you're pulling from those legs, head and chest up. Boom, don't be looking at the ground while performing that sumo deadlift.
Definitely not. So you notice I come back up.
And deadlift.
And deadlift it.
There it is. You guys got it. Getting the hang of it.
That's right. As you get the hang of it, move a little faster.
Pick up the pace as you feel more comfortable.
Woo!
Another great total body movement this one is.
And my legs are killing me, but that's okay.
We're feeling it too.
We're gonna keep on pushing through.
You got it, guys, you got it. Keep it up. Let's hit this one for just 10 more seconds, that's it. Almost there, drive through. Breathe. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, next we're gonna go ahead and get that kettlebell up into a rack position. I'm gonna go a little lighter on this one.
Yes, as am I.
We're gonna go either a side lunge, step on out to your side, this leg stays straight, or a side squat, and then press. So either side lunge or side squat. Either way, you're taking a step out to the side, putting that weight back in your hips, and then pressing straight up overhead. So basically, the longer that step is, the harder this one becomes for you. You decide which one is right for you, but just keep it moving. You can do it, guys. Keep good posture as you're coming down. It means keep that head and chest up, shoulders are up, not bending over here. Excellent. It's at 10 more seconds on this side. What you got? Put it all out there. Come on. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Nice. Switch sides.
Switching sides into that next one. Ah, we're feeling it too, guys. You're not alone. We're right there working with you. Just keep pushing, rep after rep. Only thing standing in between you and your goals is that work that needs to be put in to achieve them. And you're doing that right here, rep by rep. Keep putting in that work. Excellent. Let's hit it here for 5, 4, 3, two, one, and zero. All right, we're going to the ground for the next one into a kneeling position. On one knee, opposite knee is up. Claudia's gonna start in a rack position where I'm gonna start by doing a snatch. Bring my elbow up, flipping up top. Now we're going half Turkish get up. Outside arm on the ground. Go ahead and kick through with that down leg. Keeping your hips down, hips come up, hips down, and then return back. The entire time, keeping this arm straight. So Claudia's gonna do that press every time, where I'm gonna do that snatch every time. Again, this is a complicated move. You're not imagining it. It is gonna take you a couple reps to follow along and to get the hang of it. But once you have it, you'll have it forever. Another great compound move, working that core along with every other muscle group.
This move especially, it's not a race. You definitely wanna take your time and think about the movements as you're doing them.
And as that kettlebell is up top, it helps if you look up at it, keep your eyes up on it, especially once you get a little more familiar with the form, a little more comfortable and stable. Boom, big power. You got it, guys. Woo. Let's switch sides in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Opposite side now. Get that opposite side leg up. Everything is just mirrored now. Boom, big power. Hand down, hips up, and back. Return, nice. Stay focused on this one.
And breathe through the movement.
Focused on that form, step by step, sticking with it. Nice. Excellent work, everybody. You're a fighter, not a quitter. Keep it up. Don't pause this video. Don't stop it. No matter how tempting it may be, just keep with it, and you'll keep getting better. Promise you. Just put in that work. That's it. That magic formula that you've been looking for is just work. Let's hit it for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Nice. Ooh. Stand a bucket back up on our feet. We're gonna do a front squat plus rotational press. So weight goes back on our hips. Kettlebell's in rack position. As we stand up, we're gonna rotate and press straight up. Back on our hips, rotate, press straight up. That palm stays facing us, facing inward throughout the course of this movement. As you come up, you'll get a little bit of rotation in your feet as your core and hips rotate. Boom, punching straight up, guys. Follow all the way through and use that power from your legs to help drive that kettlebell straight up. Another total body movement. Working your hamstrings, glutes, lower back, quads, core, shoulder, tricep, all getting hit. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Switch sides. Right into the next one, let's go, you got it. Weight back in those hips. Big punch straight up. If you need to change the weight, you can always do so, but we want you to keep moving. Don't give up. Remember, you're a fighter. Not a quitter. You can do it. Push past that burn. Just keep pushing. Keep moving forward. And you got it. Keep it up, guys. Doing great. It burns so good. Let's go 10 more seconds on this one. That's it. Almost there. So close. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Oh. Oh, goodness, that was brutal.
Man.
Nice work out there.
Oh, I'm glad that one's over.
We're going to head into a quick little cool down here just to bring your heart rate down gradually.
Yep.
Why don't you go ahead and make your way on over to a wall. First, we're going to do a wall angel. Great one for shoulder mobility. Whew. You're going to bring your feet about 2 to 4 inches away from that wall. Put your lower back, glutes, upper back, head, and arms all on that wall. Keep them flat on that wall the best you can. We're gonna come up, reach up, and then pull back down from those elbows. Oh, this one is going to feel brutal after that workout. That's okay. It's just a little post-workout mobility work. Stretch up, then pull down on those elbows.
Making sure to stay flat against the wall as best as you can.
It's really hard to do, but try your best. All right, one more on this last one. Let's pull those elbows down and hold those elbows down. Keeping your whole back, head, everything flat up against that wall. Hold it, hold it. Good. Let's go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
All right.
Ah, shake it out.
All right.
All right, next we're going to do a reach to our toes. If you can't quite make it to your toes, that's okay. Do the best you can. Feet pretty close together, a little bend in our knees, just a slight bend. Reach over. If you can only make it to your shins, that's okay. Reach as far as you can. Head down, everything down. We're just going to get a good static stretch here in our posterior chain. Make sure to get some nice, slow, deep breaths while you're down here. Feel that posterior chain loosen up. Excellent. Let's hold it for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Come up slowly.
Slow.
Nice. Don't want to pass out.
No.
Now we're going to go down on the ground. We're going to do a butterfly next. Come on down to the ground. Put your feet together. Now, easier version is with your hands back behind you, but harder version is here. Bring those feet nice and close to your body the best you can. And now try to drive those knees to the ground.
Ooh.
Now you might be here, or this might all be you have today if your hips aren't quite as flexible yet. Give it your best. And we're just gonna hold that static stretch, opening up those hips. Good, nice little easy hip mobility drill here.
Nice controlled breathing. Inhale and exhale slowly.
Feel that heart rate coming back down. Let's hold it for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All right, let's come back to our feet. We're gonna do a chest opener next. We're gonna open up those shoulders in your chest. I want you to go ahead and interlock your fingers behind your back. So interlock those fingers behind your back. Now I want you to pull your shoulders back and push your chest forward at the same time. So pulling those hands back, feel that stretch in your chest and in your shoulders.
And in your biceps.
In your biceps
where
as well.
I feel mine.
And if you want a little extra stretch, you can bend over and bring those hands up overhead. We're just gonna hold this one and breathe. Keep pulling apart, keep pulling them apart. Let's go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Shake it loose.
Excellent workout today.
Excellent.
Give yourself a big pat on the back.
Excellent workout there, HASfit Tribe. Hope you enjoyed this workout as much as we obviously did. It was a real butt kicker. If you did enjoy this workout and you've been working out with us for a while, we'd encourage you to please go check out our Patreon page where you can find out more about how you can help support our cause of keeping these great workouts free.
And if you enjoyed this workout with us today, we ask that you please give this workout video a huge thumbs up and please subscribe to our YouTube channel. That way you are always notified when HASfit drops a new workout.
Make sure to visit HASfit.com for hundreds of free workouts just like this one, free meal plans, and our free complete fitness programs.
And if you're on social media, if you're on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, come find HASfit. We want to connect with you.
Thank you so much for giving us the honor and privilege of working out with you today. I'm Coach Kozak.
And I'm Claudia.
And we will see you at your next workout.